Today, we will discuss Freedom to the Slave by H.L.V. Derozio. But before that, will you allow me to take you back to 2020? It was a time of uncertainty. Most countries declared nationwide lockdown. Think about the time when we were confined within a limited space and we couldn't go out. There was no sense of time. Every day seemed the same, never ending. We felt like nobody comes, nobody goes. It's awful. Indeed, it was awful. We understood the value of freedom, however, we were certain that this would end soon. Unlike us, those innocent slaves who were captured and enslaved for years were not fortunate. I know it's an exaggeration to compare our state with the depressing state of the slave. The period of slavery was more intense, distressful than our period of quarantine or lockdown. It was just a glimpse. My point here is, if, for us, our period of lockdown was unbearable, then just think how unbearable a slave's life would be. Just think about the emotional state of a slave when he realized he would be a slave for life. But one day, a person came and set the slave free. Now, what would be the reaction of the newly liberated slave? The poet Derozio captured this reaction of the slave in the poem Freedom to the Slave. In this video, I will not discuss the poem line by line because I have already discussed that in the blog. If you are interested, you can visit the blog. The link is in the comment box. Now let's start the poem. Freedom to the Slave is about the emancipation of a newly liberated slave from bondage. The poet exclaims in wonder about the feeling of the slave when he is told that slavery has ended. The poet also emphasizes how proudly his heart beats when he realizes he is free. After the liberty from the bondage, Derozio focuses on the psychological change in the liberated slave. In slavery, a man is not only bound physically, but he is also within the mental restraint. Along with the physical torture, a slave also undergoes mental torture. Now the slave becomes jubilant. He does not need to kneel, and he stands. As he stands, his mood also uplifts. He feels he is alive again. He looks above the open sky and feels the fresh wind. He is pleased to see the flying birds and a running stream. During slavery, he was devoid of experiencing freedom, but after regaining freedom, he can now feel freedom. From now onwards, no one will govern his life. He thinks of wind, wild birds, and running stream and cries, "I am free as they." He realizes he is free like them. After the first stanza, the poet addresses freedom. He says that there is a close affinity between soul and freedom. Freedom keeps the soul alive. It is for freedom that the patriot fights and the braveheart is willing to sacrifice his life. Derozio extends his admiration to the benevolent man who empathizes with the plight of the slave and sets the slave free. Now let's discuss the theme of the poem. The theme of Freedom to the Slave is freedom. Now, what is freedom? The state of being free is freedom. But from what? It depends on the context. For instance, in the poem, for the slave, freedom means to be free from the shackles. The epigraph hints at the theme of the poem. Derozio has taken the epigraph from Thomas Campbell's poem, The Pleasure of Hope. The epigraph tells about the freedom of a captive. Derozio's poem is also about the freedom of a slave. The slave in Campbell's poem breaks the shackles and the man in him becomes alive. In Derozio's poem, the slave also feels the same. Both slavery and freedom are states, and both states are contradictory to each other. One who is in slavery can't be free, and where there is freedom, slavery can exist there. Therefore, as the slave departs, the man in him returns. The slave regains his freedom. Freedom is the fundamental aspect of man's soul. It is the freedom that keeps igniting the everlasting flame of the soul. Freedom energizes the soul. For freedom, patriots fight against the tyrannical invaders, and brave hearts are ready to sacrifice life. It is again for the freedom a generous man gives freedom to the slave. The acts of both the tyrant and the benevolent man hints to us one important aspect of freedom, and that is only the free man can value others' freedom and help others in attaining freedom. To explain, I would like to refer to Nelson Mandela's view of freedom. Mandela says in his autobiography, Long Walk to Freedom, that an oppressor who snatches someone's freedom is also a slave. He is a slave because prejudice and narrow-mindedness surround him. Just as the oppressed are slaves physically, the oppressor is a mental slave. On the other hand, the generous man is free from the prejudice against people of color and narrow-mindedness. He understands that, irrespective of skin color, we all are equal. No man is foreign. The poem reminds us of the dark phase of human history where people of color were sold and tortured to work under authoritarian men. Derozio, as a humanitarian poet, celebrates the ending of slavery. Fortunately, slavery has ended formally, but forms of slavery still exist today in the subtlest form. Let me explain what I mean. If the root of slavery is based on racial discrimination, the belief that people of color need to be subjugated and controlled, then the recent incident like the death of George Floyd in the US shows the practice of such ideology in its subtlest form. This incident is not the only one in America. In 2014, police officer Darren Wilson shot an 18-year-old black man, Michael Brown. In the same year, Eric Garner was killed. The phrase, "I can't breathe," originated from the last words of Eric Garner. Racial discrimination is a major social issue in America. Do you know what are the causes of racial discriminations? There are many, but two of them are media and education. The representation of black people in media is a factor of deep-rooted racism. The blacks in the media had been depicted for decades as villains, immoral persons. It is said that the education system is another reason. The syllabus in the American education system hardly addresses burning social problem like racism. When system like education system does not recognize and address social issues like racial discriminations, then such incidents are bound to happen. So, slavery has ended, but the minds are not yet free. I have dragged this issue into the discussion of the poem because it is relevant. And the second reason is that I think this is how literature is discussed. Let me know your views in the comment box. Thank you.